I'm Aaron. I'm a cloud developer advocate at Microsoft. And I work a lot on the Go programming language and Docker containers and some other systems that kind of revolve around containers. So today we're going to put Go and containers together. We're going to get a real Go application up onto Azure using only free tools. So everything you see today is going to be free, and it's everything that you can use as well. So we've got some documentation here that you'll be able to see in the show notes. And this kind of runs through how to get a basic Go application. You can kind of see it's just a Hello World application. And it shows you how to use Azure Web Apps to push that up into the cloud onto the free tier. So we're going to take that and do it with a real project. We're going to do it with the Athens project. So this is a server for dependency management for the Go community. So it's a big application written in Go, and it's actually pretty crucial that this server is always up and running on the internet. And we're going to show how we would do it on Azure. So first things first, we'll go into our portal. This is the Azure Web Apps portal. And I just did a refresh, do it again, and you can see there's no app services running. So I've got some commands to get an app service running here. And this is using VS Code. VS Code is also a free development environment, completely open source and support for tons and tons of languages out there. Support for Go, obviously you can see here, support for shell scripts and tons of others. So first things first here, we're going to run this first command. This is creating the new web app, and it's also telling the web app to use this Docker image. The image is docker/gomods/proxy. And this is pointing Azure Web Apps to the Docker Hub. So the Docker Hub is a public image registry that's also free for you to use. And you can host completely public images or private images. And you can push them up and you can share them and everything else kind of under the sun. So free for you to use as well. And I already pushed one up to the Docker Hub. So I'm going to copy and paste this command into my VS Code terminal. And we're going to run that. And it's going to take just a second. So I should mention that we've got some CI/CD, so some continuous integration and continuous delivery. And that's already set up for the Athens project. And part of it, after running its tests, is to push up this Docker image. So the canary image is the very, very latest code that has been written for Athens. Okay. So the second piece of creating our web app is setting up some environment variables. So these are exactly the same environment variables that we would have locally if we were to run this Docker image locally. So Azure Web Apps is going to run the exact same Docker images that we could run locally. And we'll have some docs in the show notes on how to do it locally if you'd like. So we're going to copy and paste these environment variables into our VS Code terminal as well. Press enter and run that. And we'll wait a second for that to complete. You can kind of see a summary here of all the environment variables that are set up. And then the last piece here is we're going to list out our web app. So we'll go and run this list in table format. And we can see a little bit about our web app. So first of all, it's running. It's in Western Europe. But most importantly, it's got this Athens proxy default hostname. So what this is saying to us is that Athens is running on the public internet. So we can go and check out this URL in our browser, and it'll take just a second the very first time we load it, because in the background, Azure Web Apps is actually launching the container for us. And it'll just take one more second here. And while that's running, I'll just go over here and mention one more piece. Actually, I'll go mention this in our portal. If we reload the portal here, you can see the Athens proxy is now up and running. And when we go into the Athens proxy, there's tons and tons of stuff we can do here. We can set some container settings. There are tons of app settings. There's this concept called deployment slots, which lets us set up different kind of deployment strategies. And you can see, obviously, here there's a free trial. So we are on the free tier. And actually, you can break out of the trial and still remain free as well. So we'll go back to our Athens proxy public URL. And you can see this is kind of just the Athens proxy telling us that it's running. Most of the functionality is in a REST API that the Go toolchain uses. And then you can go in here into the Athens documentation, and there's some installing instructions on how to install Docker for you locally and how to do some other kind of installation methods. So there's one last piece. I mentioned that this docker.io Athens proxy image is pushed up to Docker. And I mentioned that that's done with a continuous integration, continuous delivery system. So Azure offers a CI/CD system for free. It's called Azure DevOps, and you can go to dev.azure.com to check it out. And it has unlimited free builds with 10 concurrent builds for any open source project, and that includes Athens. So it's got some powerful stuff. We can go into Athens, and we can see there's this kind of overview pane, but we've got boards for project planning. You can, in fact, run Git repositories right inside of Athens, or excuse me, right inside of DevOps. The coolest thing to me is pipelines. That's the CI/CD. You can see I was setting it up, and my last two builds are failures, actually. You can do releases. There's all kinds of different management of concurrent tasks. And there's tons more, so I really encourage you to check that out as well. And that's kind of like going from here. You can set up a complete end-to-end pipeline from writing code all the way to getting it into production. So really cool stuff there. I really encourage you to go check out the Azure free tier. There will be a link to that as well in the show notes. So plenty of stuff for you to check out from here and this point on. And Azure has tons and tons more solutions for you to get go into the Azure cloud. And so I really encourage you to go check that out. So thanks, everybody, and we'll see you over on the internet.